Angostura is one of the iconic brands of Trinidad and Tobago, with its roots embedded in our history. Since the early 1900s, the Angostura brand has been synonymous with quality products, masterful blending, and secret recipes. Today on How We Make It, we take a look at the history and manufacturing process behind Angostura and their line of world-famous rums.
Angostura Limited has been in the rum business since the turn of the 20th century, blending and bottling under its own name. In 1936, the great-grandson of Dr. Seagut established a chemical control and research laboratory and thus ushered the company into the 20th century. By 1949, based on extensive research into the processes of fermentation and distillation, the company established Trinidad Distillers Limited and erected its first distillery, thereby making Angostura a major rum producer. In 1973, Angostura Holdings Limited purchased Fernandez Distillers Limited from J.B. Fernandez.
The only way you can make rum is if you start off with sugar that comes from sugar cane. The actual form that sugar takes is not critical, but it must be sugar from sugar cane.
The production process begins with the delivery of molasses to the plant. Molasses is a byproduct of the cane sugar manufacturing process and is itself a concentrated sugar solution. The molasses is dissolved in water and placed into large tanks called fermenters. Angostura uses its own special yeast to carry out its fermentation. At the start of the fermentation process, a nitrogen fertilizer is added as a yeast nutrient. No other additives are introduced before going to the fermentation stage. The mixture is then circulated with the use of pumps through heat exchangers to cool the liquid. Notice the heat that is generated in the fermentation process. In distillation, heat in the form of steam is used in the giant multi-tray columns to extract and refine the alcohol from the wash, or what is now called the fermented mash. The mash only carries about 8% alcohol. However, after the distillation process, the alcohol content is increased to about 80 to 90%. Careful attention is paid to the process, and the entire distillery is monitored by a control room to maintain safety and product consistency. The aging process introduces an age-old art of storing the alcohol in once-used bourbon casks. The casks are purposely charred to release the subtle flavors found in the oak barrels and are assembled and repaired on-site at the cooper's shed. After the barrels are filled, they are all stored in a bonded area called the aging warehouse. At the end of the aging process, the alcohol is blended to make the perfect rum. The bottling process begins with the bottles being stacked onto a fully automated production line. The cases are first stacked upside down on the pallets, allowing the line workers to easily place new bottles into the production line. The empty bottle inspector uses photograph analysis technology to determine if there are any inconsistencies or particles in the bottles. Then it's off to the filling station where the bottles are filled and capped, all behind a protective screen, further preventing impurities from entering the bottles. An automated labeling machine glues the fresh labels right onto each bottle. Each one is then gently brushed to secure the label to the front and back. After filling, the inspection is done using gamma rays to confirm that the bottle is correctly filled, labeled, and capped. The date is then printed on by a specially designed inkjet printer in the blink of an eye. Lastly, the bottles are then packed into cases and stacked pallets high, awaiting the next order for Angostura rum.